to me, she goes, he spoke through a blooming nigger, greased all over with coconut oil, she goes, go, blimey, I couldn't stand her. Bloody old cow, I said, and with that I fetched her a biff on the ear while you're silly.
You're a liar, cocky.
You've never been New Guinea in your life, I'm thinking.
You think of it. You say she was cannibal, cocky.
Yeah. How could you doubt it, Emily? A queen of the niggers she must have been, surely. Who else would think herself equal to falling in love with a beautiful devil-may-care rig of a man that like a cop?
Now don't strike me dead if it ain't true. Every bleeding word of it. After 10 years ago come Christmas. It was a Christmas dinner she had her eyes on.
Ain't it been a tough old bird, eh?
Looking for the ball we hit his kid. For the Queen of the Cannibal Oils would have died in the bellyache the day after Christmas and double a dose of it.
Ah, you
blasted
bag.
We best not be talking so loud and into it. Have a bit of a sleep. You'd be wanting a drink of water, maybe. Ah, to sleep he is, sure enough. His breath is choking in his throat like water gurgling in a pipe. Poor devil.
It's either the sight for him, God help him.
Stop your croaking. He's not dead yet. Praise God he'll have many a long day yet before him.
Oh, he's bad. He's very bad. His light would have gone out after a fall like that.
Yeah, you saw him fall?
Right next to him. He and me was going down in number 2 hole to do some chipping. He puts his leg over careless like and misses the ladder. Plump straight down to the bottom. I was scared to look over for a minute. Then I heard him groan and I scuttled down after him. He was hurt bad inside, but the blood was dripping from the side of his mouth. He was groaning hard, but he never let a word out of him.
Yes, and you blokes remember when we hauled him in here? Oh well, he says. Oh well. Like that, and nothing else.
Did the captain know where he is hurt in?
Ah, that silly old Josser. What the hell would he know about anything? He fits in his mouth in a bit of glass.
The devil's own life, 'tis, to be out on a lonely sea with nothing between you and a grave in the ocean. For the spindle shank grapist could all fool the like of him. It was enough to make a saint swear to see him with his gold watch in his hand, trying to look as wise as an owl on a tree. And all the time not knowing whether it was cholera or the barber's itch was the matter with him.
He gave him a dose of salts and he dumped.
That's the thing he gave him at all. But looked in the book he had with him and shook his head and walked out without saying a word. The second mate after him no wiser than himself. God's curse on the two of them.
Yank was a good shipman. Poor beggar. Let me fool Bob in New York, he did.
A good shipmate he was. And is. None better. You said no more than the truth, cocky. 5 years and more it is since first I shipped with him. And we've stuck together ever since, through good luck and bad. Oh, fights we've had. God help us. But with only one we'd a bit of a drink taken. And we always shook hands the next morning. Whatever was his was mine. And many's the time I'd have been on the beach.
Almost, but for him.
And now? Don't take me if I'm not starting to blow like an old woman. And he not dead at all, but going to live many a long year yet married.
This may be doing good. It seems better now.
If you would eat something,
would you have me eaten in ill condition?
Sure, it's hard enough on the rest of us with nothing the matter with our insides to be stomaching the scuff on this rusty lime juice.
Can't face it, Shep. Plenty of work. No food. The owner's riding round in carriages.
Hash, hash. Stew, marmalade, pipe down. Bloody swill. Fit up with the swine is what I say.
And the dishwater they disguise by the name of tea.
God.
The putty they call bread.
My belly feels like it swallowed a dozen rivets at the thought. And sea biscuits that'd break the teeth of a lion if he had the misfortune to take a bite at one.
And not in potatoes. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Shut the mouth, Harvey.
It's a hell of a thing for us to be complaining about our guts. And a sick man may be dying listening to us. God, stiffen you, squint. It's good. Put that organ of yours down or I'll break your ugly face for you. That banshee screeching fit music for a sick man.
All right, all right.
Damn this fog. My lookout next, too. Must be nearly 8 bells, boys.
Nothing but your dirty weather all this voyage.
I can't sleep when this will blow.
If this fog keeps up, I'm telling you, we'll not be in Cardiff for a week or more.
It was just such a night as this that the old Dover went down. Just about this time it was, too. We all sitting around in the forecastle, yanked beside me, and all of a sudden we hear this great slither and crash, and the ship heeled over till we was all in a heap on one side.
What came after, I just remember exactly.
Except it was a hard ship to get the boat over the side before the old tea kettle sank. Yank was in the same boat with me. In 7 mortal days we drifted with scarcely a drop of water or a bite to chew on. It was the Yankee that held me down when I wanted to jump into the ocean, roaring mad with the thirst. Picked up we were on the same day, with only the Yankee in his senses and him steering the port.
Blimey, but you're a cheerful blighted Driscoll. Talking about shipwrecks in this here blushing fog.
Are you feeling better, Yankee? Sure, you must be. You look as strong as an ox. Am I telling him a lie?
A stripes done you good. Here, you'll be having your pint of beer in Cardiff this day week.
And fish and chips, man.
What are you all lying for? You think I'm afraid to...
Oh, don't be thinking such things.
I'm dying, I tell you. I won't stay here alone when everyone's snoring. So I'll go out on deck. Somebody made this.
Oh, don't be worrying, Yank. I'll not move a step out of here. And let that devil of a bosun curse his black head off. You speak a word to the bosun, Cocky. Tell him that Yank is bad talk, and I'll be staying with him for a while yet.
Right.
Blimey.
The fog's
thick as soon. Are you satisfied now, Yank? Oh, he's faint. God help him. He's burning up. Maybe this will cool you down.
I thought I was gone then. What do you want to wake me for?
Is it wishful for heaven you are?
Hell. I guess.
For the love of the saints, don't be talking like that. You give a man the creeps. It's chip and rust on the deck you'll be in a day or two with the best of us.
How's Yank?
Better. Ask him yourself. He's awake.
I'm all right, Smitty.
Glad to hear it, Hank.
You feel good, John?
Yeah, Eva.
Oh, that's good.
Goodbye. And good luck to the lot of you.
Is it paining you again?
Hurts like hell. Here. I guess my old pump's busted. Oh.
Yank!
Yank!
What is it? Are you running for the captain?
Don't leave me, Nick. Don't leave me alone. Don't. What?
Oh, blood again. We'd best be getting the captain.
No, don't leave me. If you do, I'll get up and follow you. I ain't no coward, but I'm scared to stay here with all of them asleep and snoring. Captain can't do me no good. You know it yourself. Pain ain't so bad now. But I thought it had me then. It was like a buzz saw cutting in.
Oh, God blast it.
Watch your step, Captain.
Thank you, Robinson.
And how is the sick man?
All right, sir.
And the pain in the chest?
Still hurts, sir. Worse than ever.
Here. Be sure and keep this in under your tongue, not over it.
Oh.
Isn't this your watch on deck, Driscoll?
Yes, sir. But Yank was fearing to be alone, and I
can't... That's all right, Driscoll.
Thank you, sir.
The light so I can read this thermometer. It's way up. Both of them. He has been spitting blood again.
Not much for the orders pass, sir. But before that...
A great deal?
Yes, sir.
He hasn't eaten anything?
No, sir.
Did he drink that medicine I sent?
Yes, sir, but it didn't stay down.
I'm afraid he's very weak. I can't do anything else for him. It's too serious for me. If this had only happened a week later, we'd be in Cardiff in time to...
Please help him some way, sir.
But my good man, I'm not a doctor. You and he have been shipmates for a long time.
5 years and more, sir.
I see. Well, don't let him move. Keep him quiet and we'll hope for the best. I'll read the matter up and send him some medicine. Something to ease the pain, anyway. Now, keep up your courage. You'll be better tomorrow. We'll pull you through all right, and we'll... Coming, Robinson?
I tell you, he wasn't half as sick as he thought you was. The captain will have you out on deck coursing and swearing like a trooper before the week is out.
Don't lie, Drisk. I heard what he said. And if I didn't, I could tell by the way I feel. I know what's going to happen. I'm going to die, that's what. And the sooner, the better.
No! And be damned to you. You're not. I'll not let you.
It ain't no use, Drisk. I ain't got a chance, but I ain't scared. Give me a drink of water, will you, Drisk? My throat's burning up.
Feeling more lazy like now.
that I know it's all up. You mustn't take it so hard, Drisk. I was just thinking, it ain't as bad as people think. Dying. I never took much stock in the truck them sky pilots preach. I ain't never had religion. But I know whatever it is, what comes after, it can't be no worse than this. I don't like to leave you, Drisk, but that's all.
Oh, lad, don't be talking.
Sailor's life ain't much to cry about, Lickman. It's one ship after another. Hard work. Small pay. Bum grub. And when we get into port just to drink, it's not been a fight. And all your money gone, and then you ship away again. Never meeting no nice people. Never getting out of sailor town hardly in any port. Traveling all over the world and never seeing none of it. Without no one to care whether you're alive or dead. There ain't much in all that that'd make you sorry to lose it, Drift.
Oh, it's a hell of a life, you see.
Must be great to stay on dry land all your life. Have a farm. With a house of your own. With cows, and pigs, and chickens. Way in the middle of the land. Where you'd never smell the sea or see a ship. Must be great to have a wife and kids to play with at night after supper. When your work was done, it must be great to have a home of your own, Drisk.
It must surely. What's the use of talking of it? Such things are not for the likes of us.
Farron, it's all right when you're young and you don't care. But we chickens no more, and somehow, I don't know, this last year has seemed rotten. And I've had a bunch. I quit. With you, of course. And we'd save our coin and go to Canada. Or Argentine, or someplace, and get a farm. Just a small one. Just enough to live on. I never told you this. Because I thought you'd laugh at me.
Laugh at you, is it? When I'm having the same thoughts myself, time after time. Oh, it's a grand idea. And we'll be doing it, sure. If you'll stop your crazy notions about being so sick.
It's too late. We shouldn't have made this trip and then. Does all the fog get in here?
Fog?
Everything looks misty. Must be my eyes getting weak, I guess. Well, what was he talking about a minute ago? A farm. It's too late. Argentine, did I say? You remember the times we had in Buenos Aires? The moving pictures and barracks. Some class to them, you remember?
I do that. And so does the piano player. And he'll not be forgetting the black oil you gave him in a hurry.
Yeah, I remember the time We was there on the beach and had to go to Tommy Moore's boarding house to get shipped. And he sold us rotten oil skins and sea boots full of holes and shipped us on a skysail yarder round the Horn and took 2 months pay for it.
Going deep.
And the days we used to sit on the park benches along the Paseo Colon with the vigilantes looking hard at us. And the songs and the sailor's opera where the guy played ragtime. Remember them?
I do, sure.
And La Plata, the stink of the high. I always liked Argentine. All except that booze, kinda. Oh, damn, we used to get on that, remember?
Could I forget it? My head tans me at the mention of that devil's brew.
Remember the night I went crazy with the heat in Singapore? Yeah, the time you was pinched by the cops in Port Said, and the times we was both locked up in Sydney for fighting.
I do so.
And that fight on the dot in Cape Town.
Don't be thinking of that now. Tis past and gone.
You think he'll hold it up against me?
Who's that?
God. They say he sees everything. He must know it was done in a fair fight, in self-defense, don't you think?
Of course! You stabbed him, and be damned to him for the skulking swine he was. After him trying to stick you on the back, and you not suspecting. Let your conscience be easy. I wished I had nothing blacker than that on my soul. And I'd not be afraid of the angel Gabriel himself.
I could see him a minute ago, with the blood spurting out of his neck.
Oh, the fever it is that makes you see such things. Give no heed to it.
You don't think he'll hold it up against me? God, I mean?
If there's justice in heaven, no.
We won't reach Cardiff for a week. At least. I'll be buried at sea.
Shh! I won't listen to you.
It's as good a place as any other, I suppose. Only I always wanted to be buried on dry land. But what the hell will I care? Then. Why should it be a rotten night like this? With that damn whistle blown and people snoring all around. I wish the stars was out. And the moon, too. I could lie out on deck and look at them. I need to make it easier to go. Somehow.
For the love of God, don't be talking like that.
Whatever pay is coming to me, you can divvy up with the rest of the boys. And you take my watch. It ain't worth much. But it's all I've got.
Have you no relations at all to call your own?
No. Not as I know of. One thing I forgot. You know Fanny, the barmaid at the Red Stork in Cardiff?
Sure, and who doesn't?
She's been good to me. She tried to lend me half a crown when I was broke there last trip. Buyer, the biggest box of candy you can find in Cardiff. It's
destroy the ship on this voyage I'm going on. Alone. My throat's like a furnace. Give me a drink of water, will you, dear?
Oh, sure.
I wish this was a pint of beer. Oh.
Oh, God, Yank, what is it?
Shalom. Drink. Who's there?
Who? What?
Pretty lady dressed in black.
Yank. Oh, Yank. Yank, say a word for me, for the love of heaven.
Oh, Frisco, can you leave Yank for off the man? I'll give you an hand.
Yank. Yank.
The pub's licked it.
Oh, my God. I'm hardly sorry.
Oh, saying his prayers.
Your friends. And I guess. But I sinned.
Oh, blimey.
Through my fall. Through my fall. Through my fall.